Are there any, is there any doubt anymore? And I wasn't going to, like I said, I wasn't going to say anything while he was alive because a promise is a promise. But you see me cussing him out, mad at him. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. Wait, you want to see it again? You want to see it again? Huh? I'll show it to you again. I think you might want to see it again. Here, October 1st, 2020. So, I don't know. Is his channel still up? I don't check. But it must have been September, the end of September that he did a video. And if it coincides with what I'm saying, unless he took it down because he was trying to, you know, get me not to be mad at him anymore, it should still be there. Here you go, putting my name in your mouth on your YouTube channel. Your word means nothing. So I'm having a temper tantrum, you guys. You said... I can't even fucking listen to your bullshit. You twist everything I say. Does that sound like somebody that was it? What are you talking about? Your living vicariously bullshit video. Do you realize that when you include my name with some of the members of your site, wait, if you realize that when you include my name with some of the members of your psychotic audience, they come to terrorize me. That's not my intention. I'll address that. Whatever. Look, I don't condone that. So yes, I'll deal with it. You don't condone it. You said you wouldn't mention my name anymore. And you went back on your word. I slip up. I'm not perfect. I won't again. Well, I don't believe you. You have my word. Doesn't mean much. You already broke your word. No, I slipped up. Does that sound like your big, strong, fuck these bitches? Oh, fuck these bitches. Wait, 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 wait. Where's my cigar? No, before I start this masterpiece, I have a CBD vape. Wait, I didn't get anything this time. Now, before I start this masterpiece, who does that sound like?
Ms. Karazin, before I go, I want to make something abundantly clear to you. All right? You're basic, okay? You are not a hot woman, okay? You're not a hot, mature, post-wall. You're nothing, okay? You're the bottom of the barrel of a girl next door. Like, if that was a metric, you know, just the girl next door stereotype, the plain Jane. You, if it was between 1 and 3, you are 3, okay? Right? You've never been anything. You've never been hot or anything, okay? You're not overtly attractive. You're not even moderately attractive. You're not objectively beautiful. You're just plain. You're blah. You're nothing, okay? And it was made abundantly clear to me years ago when I saw you at that YouTube convention walking up and down the Hilton, you know, the Hilton, right? I think on Century Boulevard near LAX. Yeah, you were walking around through there, and nobody knew who you were, gave a shit. No one saw you. You had to go to your events or whatever to do whatever. And then you were stalking that one black content creator, a really popular black content creator. You were at his arm and he couldn't be bothered with you. Right? He just like, you know, he was like, kind of like, eh, you know, you're nothing. Okay. And you're messy as fuck. All right. And you're petty. Okay. This is disgusting. And you should be dragged from pillar to post, ma'am. Okay, you should be dragged from pillar to post for this. Okay, at least have the common decency, if you had this evidence, to do it when the shit went across your phone. All right, you know, whatever, you know, whenever it went across your phone. All right, just get it out and open while the man's still alive. Okay? I want to tell you, Miss Carrison, I don't care if the shit's true. Okay, no one gives a fuck. David Carroll is dead. All right? And I want to let you know that, you know, I don't know if you know this, but you might. I would believe that you do know this. One of your other enemies from the past, Brian Solange, built a website called Free Speech Avenger. Okay? Free Speech Avenger. It's been taken down because of the irresponsible actions of another member of that supposed manosphere and shit. You know, he self-proclaimed, by the way. You know, this guy went on a rampage with his gun in New York. All right? So the FBI went to Mr. Solange's site and dismantled it and shit and took it for evidence. Okay? But all of David Carroll's shit was on there. Okay? All of his shit was on there. And I used to watch his shit. I used to watch his episodes or whatever, or podcasts, whatever the fuck you want to call them and shit. And he never mentioned you. Okay? Nor should he. I would be ashamed to mention you too. You're like that character Jamie Foxx used to portray on In Living Color. You're like Wanda and shit, of Plain Jane's the metric 1 to 3. You're 3. Barely a 3. You're almost a 4 in a scale from 1 to 3, okay? Of basic biatches. Okay, I want to tell you that David Carroll, you telling us, you coming over here, you're on your fucking live telling us that he was an op in the manosphere doesn't mean a goddamn thing. It doesn't hold fucking water and shit, because on those episodes, he talked about his disdain for the manosphere and shit, okay, and that he didn't want to be seen as a part of a whole group. He talked about that all the fucking time and shit, and he did obsess over a woman and shit, and it wasn't you. You know, I think it was this woman named Yvette Irene. You know, I may get that wrong. But it wasn't you, okay? And it never will be you. You, even in David Carroll's, you know, mind and shit, whatever he was doing, it was always someone else. It was never going to be you. Never will be you. Yvette Irene, it was her. All right? He used to always talk about how she wore tight clothing, and that she was showing off her large breasts. Yes, he was saying that, and I can say that now because he's dead, Kristen. He's dead, Pink Pill. Okay, he's long dead. Okay, he was an older gentleman and shit, and he was by himself for some reason. He did have family members, obviously, and shit. We wouldn't have known that he was dead. All right, he would go to the park and record his you know, episodes. You know, I forgot what he called them. He would record his fucking episodes. I believed him when he said he was a lone wolf. I was on that fucking website. The shit that I posted on that website, if I posted it on this platform and shit, somebody would be knocking on my door and shit, and I'd be receiving a bunch of letters in the mail. Let's put it that way. It was a great place to be and shit for a short time. Okay, I put a lot of cool shit on there, like with no filter, right? But you're going to get the no filter today. You're going to be the recipient of this because you're crass and boorish, okay? All right, I don't feel the need to be a gentleman with you, okay? Because you're not a lady, okay? You're dragging a dead body through the fucking streets for you because you're invisible, because you're made of glass. You got a glass jaw. You're the female equivalent of Glass Joe in the divestor game, in the misandry game and shit. You need men, okay? We don't need you. Okay, and your sisters in the game definitely don't need you. You don't appear on Fox News or any of that shit. You wasted your fucking time pushing your agenda and shit and putting your messy life all over the internet and shit. And what has it got you? You're sitting on your couch in a rather bland-looking living space and shit. You know, you need to turn this shit off and get to doing the rest of you. You do you, okay? Like, we know about all your failed relationships with Brad. You know, all of them, because you put it on. We know about the supposed black man that made $8 million a year, and he's black. We know about that. It was a blatant betrayal of your sisterhood, and that's why they shunned you and shit in part. Okay, you're just mediocre and shit. Nobody wants to buy your stupid classes and learn how to be a third level Plain Jane and shit in the metric of 1 to 3. Right? Yeah, you talked about Yvette Irene's big tits. Okay, I don't know the female and shit. I just found a few pictures that so that you can look at them and see that she wasn't shit. Okay? You definitely ain't shit compared to her. Does that hurt? Does it hurt knowing that you'll always be the Plain Jane and shit? I remember when you invaded Jason Black's show. You know, he called yourself doing that. You know, you don't get it. We know your little weird-ass chicken voice when we hear it, that weird, entitled chicken voice you have, okay? And Jason gave you the business. He gave you the business. And all you could say was that you were beautiful and fabulous and shit. And I want to tell you, you're not beautiful and fabulous, okay? You have a slender build. I told you your face is blah, okay? Easily adaptable, you know, if you put a pillowcase over the head, okay? You're nothing, okay? You got no cheeks. You got nothing up front. You're a member, the inaugural member of the Flapjack Club, okay? Does that hurt? All right, you're dragging a dead man through the street, okay? I don't care what his relationship was with you, okay? We used to watch his shit, okay? It was very entertaining and very insightful, okay? He was not lying and shit. You know, I feel bad. You women, with your mindset and the other Miss Sanders and the other insane female clan members, have gone out of your way to make this man a prophet and a lot of our other fallen, you know, godfathers and brothers and shit. You've turned them into prophets. And that's because you can't change. You can't change, okay? You won't change. And you're going to be forced to change this shit because you're post-wall, okay? And you're not a member of the sisterhood, okay? You have a ceremonial place in it at this point. If even that, and I'm being nice, this is a man talking to you, a black man, a misogynist anarchist, okay, who believes that our community needs a hard reset. All right, I don't appreciate this shit, okay? That's why I took the time out to make this second episode, okay? I wanted to make sure that you knew that you weren't sitting on top of no fucking mountain. You were not the be-all and end-all for David fucking Carroll, okay, who's dead. He's dead, Chrislyn. Okay, you have no respect for the dead. All right? I don't care if he wanted to smell your panties or not. I don't care. I think it's disgusting. I have a disdain for women that behave in this manner, this performative behavior. It's like, oh, he fucked me before. Look, that guy fucked me. Look at my dirty drawers with the skid mark in it. That's what it's equivalent of verbally listening to this bullshit. And you sitting up there thinking you're throwing darts and shit, throwing javelins into the, what you think is a group of men who even give a shit about you. They're not talking about you, Chrislyn. They're talking about the white girl now, okay? They're talking about the white girl and shit. And don't get it twisted. Don't get it twisted. I am not recognized by that group that you hate so much. I am I follow the tenets of SYSBM, okay? You know what that means, right, bitch? It means save yourself, black man.
Who does that one? So I don't think there should be any more questions. Are there any questions? Yes, you're right. The power of the P. So ladies, let this be a lesson to you. They can talk all that shit, but there is something about a woman that is irresistible. And once you learn that, you'll get further. And when I see that, hell yeah, I'm going to use it to my advantage. What fool would not? No evidence. See, this is what I hope. I don't know what more I could show you. Like, look up the number and look. I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell you. And here's what I say. Some people ask, does Chrislyn hate black men? No. But I can say that the majority of the black manosphere, yeah. I have black men in my life, in my real life. And they don't act like this. They don't act like y'all. They think y'all crazy. But even David Carroll thought y'all were crazy. Even David Carroll thought you were. Even David Carroll thought you guys were a bunch of buffoons. If you like, I can scroll through and give you screenshots of him talking about y'all and calling you monkeys. Because he did call you monkeys all the time. He called y'all monkeys.
When divestment is your identity, it is who you are. You want everybody to know about it. You have the zeal of the newly converted. But divestment, at its core, should be about realizing and working through your anger, your frustration, your disappointment. It shouldn't be a recurring loop in your head, like when you like a really cool song that you want to play on repeat over and over and over again, forever and ever, amen? That's not what I'm talking about. We all go through the divestment phase. We go through the phase of being angry, feeling less than, feeling rejected. And so we decide we don't want any more of that. We want to move past that. And so we make certain decisions based on abandoning a set of rules, cultures, and communities that don't serve us. And one thing that we do is we move away from the restrictions of relationships when it comes to what people expect or who people expect Black women to be and be with. It's not about the men, but what divestment as an identity has become for some of us is the identity of hating the men that you used to love. So what is the point of going through all of the stress, the pain, and the grief of moving yourself from a community that is male-focused, based on love and protection, only to jump to another community where those same males are still your focus? But the love that you have has now become contempt on this side. And the focus is not on you. It's not about you doing you. It's about what the fuck Black men did today.
Y'all, it's beautiful out here. I'm like, and one of them makes $7 million a year. And he's Black.
My love to me. Put on the telly. To the BBC. To the BBC. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
BBC One. BBC Two. BBC Three. BBC Four. BBC Five. BBC Six. BBC Seven.
And he's Black.
Ooh. Really, Pink Pill? I mean, that's great. It's awesome that he makes $7 million annually. That's dope. I'm happy for you, but I mean, I thought this was a swirling platform. I thought you were a swirler. I thought you were divested. I'm not trying to go back to the you know, the mud.
Yes.
Thank you. Y'all think I hate Black men? Whatever. Like I said, I don't care anymore what you think. For those of you who are shocked that I said what I just said, it's because you weren't listening. You weren't listening when I told you to pick the best man for the job.
Yeah, with an emphasis on Black women getting out of their comfort zone and exploring their options with other races of men. Right? Interracial dating. So, why? I mean, if you want to date a Black guy, Pink Pill, date a Black guy, but just please, please, please keep him off the platform and keep that Black love shit to yourself.
Y'all, it's beautiful out here. I'm like, And one of them makes $7 million a year. And he's black.
The only thing you're interested in is for yourself. And by the way, I do have to speak on behalf of black men everywhere where I say it takes a certain type of mental and emotional imbalance to be married to a white man and make a career of talking about black men. Because if I was your husband, I'd have left you at a bus station in Poughkeepsie somewhere. If I woke up every day and you were talking about black men as much as you do, because clearly you're obsessed with black men. And the only reason you got the white guy around is for gutter sex. And if I were him, I would be too offended to have a wife who makes a career out of this kind of thing. But that's just for me right here. He's probably different, and what he's getting from you is probably, you know, some really mammy-ish Aunt Jemima thing. So I mean, hey, to each his own there, I understand. But I would just say, if it were me, there's no way in the hell I would have my wife talking about how much she doesn't like black men and then is running around talking about that. I just wouldn't do that myself. It takes a special type of emotional imbalance to marry a white man and spend all day talking about black men. This is some cuck behavior, if I may just be brutally honest. This is some cuck behavior. If I were him, I would tell you the very next YouTube video, post, or comment you make about a black man, I am out of here. But then again, he and I are two different types of people. I'm a man. And he's married to you.
Well, luckily, I'm not married to you.
Dear, you're 40. You're 40 something years old. Ain't nobody checking for you, babe.
And gorgeous.
Okay, and that's gotten you what?
I'm gorgeous.
First of all, you that's an opinion. First of all, that's an opinion. Second of all, so what? Halle Berry's gorgeous, and she beats the socks off of you, and both of you are not really, and neither of you is something a black man wants, and neither of you is something that a black man's trying to wife up or keep. Imagine that. Imagine that. What's a white, what is a black man going to do? What is a black man going to do with a 45-year-old, over-the-hill, swirler black female? What's he going to do with you, Crystalin? What? Tell me.
I don't care. That's
yes,
the
you should
thing.
Because
I don't care.
Because if they can't do anything
I
with
really
you, then
don't.
You're not gorgeous if they can't do nothing with you. That's like a Ferrari with no motor. You're not gorgeous. You're just a used to be gorgeous, used to be car. Trying to get
okay,
by
hon,
trying
if
to
that's
talk
what you think,
you're trying to talk your
I'm
way
glad
into desirability.
A lot of men don't believe what you believe.
Dear,
it's
only
all, it's
the
all
only,
about
okay,
the numbers, lady.
The only thing that
go
a man's
going to
do with Crystalin is have
you
sex with her,
with
but he ain't going
to
keep
like
her.
This.
Nobody's going
to
keep
you.
You're going
to
be like Sidibe. By the way, Sidibe can get
doesn't
sex.
Have to call you
what
name,
does that mean?
Lady.
Sidibe is able to get men to have sex with her. And guess what? Crystalin can get dudes to have sex with her. You know what that proves? That the bar is just that damn low. It's not something big that you gotta hop over. The bar is just that low. And what does she come out with? Well, they'll have sex with me. They'll have sex with me. I'm gorgeous. They'll have sex with me. First of all, gorgeous is an opinion. It's an opinion. Second of all, it don't mean nothing. How many of them are willing to part with resources? Now, there's a better question. Everybody's willing to part with some sex. Is anybody willing to part with resources with Crystalin? Anybody? Anyone? Well, the girl who swirls hung up. The girl who swirls tapped out. Was it something I said?
So I rock him for his camera. I'm a gangster motherfucker, and I'm standing on that shit. We just stuffed in with them tools that's gon' hammer in this bitch. Yeah, trapping for bags of bad. We can go mad for mad. These niggas false, they bad. How you gon' rag to rag? Book bag got the big pump. Like high school, you can get jumped. Can't play me like a weak punk. Hey, bend it over, let me see something. Hey, tell my mom
like a Tonka. GD crazy like my Arca. This not a Honda. Hellcat laugh like some Thonda. Fuck 12, fuck you on them. All these little rappers think they tough. I swear to God, I don't give two fucks. Our nuts hanging, we gang banging. We bet who first to fuck some more.
What the
Crunk ain't dead, my nigga.
This message has been paid for by the Dusties. Yes, the niggas you love to hate.